I'm Brendan Shanahan of the National Hockey League's Department of Player Safety. Throughout the season, we will provide video examples of both legal hockey plays and illegal plays that rise to the level of supplemental discipline. We hope to give players, clubs, and fans a better feel for how the league views such plays. We work within the rules and interpretations of the NHL rulebook. Our mandate is not necessarily to judge if an infraction is a penalty, but to determine the degree, and then decide whether additional discipline may be required. Although no two plays are ever exactly alike, these examples should serve as reference points and guidelines for similar plays. These videos will be available for all to view on NHL.com. Hockey is a physical game, and unfortunately, injuries occur. We remind all players, it's their responsibility when delivering a check to adhere to all rules. Most importantly, making sure to hit through the body without targeting or picking your opponent's head. In addition, to minimize potential injury, the player receiving the check must still be aware of his surroundings and any impending legal check. It's important to remember that in order for a hit to result in violation of Rule 48, illegal check to the head needs to be both the principal point of contact and targeted. While we chose hits that did involve head contact in these next examples, some of them even the principal point of contact, we felt that the head was not targeted in any of them. These are hard, legal, full body checks. None of these upcoming examples broke any NHL rule, and so none resulted in a penalty or a suspension.
Zeno, official partner of the New York Rangers. For details, visit foxwoods.com/NYE.
What a hit. On the hit. They were both going for the puck. And I think when Phaneuf looked up, he just kept going. Looked like he kept his elbow down and his arm down. But he got him with his shoulder.
Jokinen ahead, Skinner to work, and look out, Sutton, big hit. And there was nothing wrong with that one.
No, that's just running into a real big man with your head down. I mean, Andy Sutton is making a solid hit here on Jeff Skinner, but this is a good hit by Andy Sutton.
As Hudler's on, look out, what a hit. Oh my, Cronwall just nailed Voracek.
You can see the contact. It's not even his shoulder in the head, it's down on the bicep almost. He really had his head down, looking back to pull the puck up, and his head was down lower than it would normally be if he's skating.
Now Stepan again, comes on, gets to the right.
What a solid hit by Chris Neal on Brian Boyle. He came right across through the middle of the ice and dropped the shoulder right into him.
Young big defenseman. Losing a battle along the boards. Jackets Dorsett with a good open ice hit there on Jedlicki.
There are two things that you have to do in this game of hockey. Number one, you are responsible as a puck carrier to have your head up. And in that situation, that's shoulder to shoulder. Good job right there by number 15.
Wing drops for Kessel, saucer for Lyles. Oh my, what a hit.
Shoulder check there. And I think that's a good hit.
Out to center, oh, and Weber came through the middle and laid out Pandolfo.
A very nice body check.
Thomas whacks it off the end board. Boychuk, green light hit. That's a pretty good hit as long as he didn't launch. Boychuk has to deal with that puck. It's down in and around his feet on the wrap around. By the time he collects it, doesn't have a chance to get his head up. Big time hit by Chris Neal.
The following are examples of hits where the head was both the principal point of contact and targeted. All four examples resulted in a suspension. 1:46 of the first period, Buffalo forward Brad Boys delivers an illegal hit to the head of Toronto player Joe Colborn. As you can see, the video shows that Colborn's head is the principal point of contact of Boys' hit. While this play develops quickly, Colborn makes no sudden movements just prior to or simultaneous with the hit, placing the onus on Boys not to hit him in the head. At 5:26 of the third period, Detroit defenseman Brendan Smith delivered an illegal hit to the head of Chicago forward Ben Smith, causing him to lose consciousness. As the video shows, although the Chicago player Ben Smith slightly changes his path, the positioning of his head does not significantly change, so the onus remains upon Detroit's Brendan Smith to deliver a full body check. Instead, Brendan Smith misses and recklessly targets his opponent's head. At 3:23 of the third period, Edmonton defenseman Andy Sutton delivered an illegal hit to the head of Colorado forward Gabriel Landeskog. The video shows that as Landeskog looks back to receive a pass in the neutral zone, Sutton steps up in anticipation of delivering a hit. Sutton takes an improper route to Landeskog and does not deliver a full body check. Instead, he picks Landeskog's head. At 9:11 of the first period, St. Louis defenseman Ian Cole delivered an illegal hit to the head of Detroit forward Justin Abdelkader. As the video shows, Abdelkader receives a pass up the middle of the ice from teammate Jonathan Erickson as he is approaching the attacking blue line. When skating up the middle on a play like this, all players understand the danger and should expect that a good hard full body check could be looming. However, what no player should expect any longer is that his head will be picked and made the principal point of contact, whether intentionally or recklessly. As Abdelkader is receiving and settling the puck, Cole approaches, fresh from a line change. Cole overshoots Abdelkader, delivering a shoulder check not square through the body, but instead past the body and into his opponent's jaw. If Cole decides to attempt a hit while approaching at this angle, he must hit Abdelkader square through the body and avoid picking his head. It is important to note that in spite of the fact that Abdelkader is moving up the ice, neither his speed nor his head positioning significantly change just prior to contact.
We hope this helps you better understand how the Department of Player Safety evaluates hard legal checks that may involve head contact versus illegal checks to the head, where the head is the principal point of contact, and either recklessly or intentionally targeted.